Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org, and today I will show you how to generate unique primary key values with JPA and Hibernate. But before we start, I want to know how you get the primary key values in your application. Do you use natural keys or UUIDs? Or do you generate technical IDs? Please post a comment below and tell me about it. I prefer to generate simple, numerical technical IDs like you can see in the code snippet, instead of using natural keys, which often require the combination of multiple attributes. Technical IDs are easier to manage, and all involved systems, mainly the database and Hibernate, can index them very efficiently. This allows you to focus on the business logic of your application and avoids performance issues. The JPA specification supports four different primary key generation strategies, which generate the primary key values programmatically, or use database features like auto-incremented columns or sequences. The only thing you have to do is to add the generated value annotation to your primary key attribute and choose a generation strategy. The generation type auto is the default generation type and lets the persistence provider choose the generation strategy. If you use Hibernate as your persistence provider, it selects a generation strategy based on the database specific dialect. For most popular databases, it selects generation type sequence, which I will explain later. This might seem like a good and easy to use option. But you will run into issues when Hibernate decides to change the selected generation type. It did that in version 5 when it started using the table strategy instead of the much better identity strategy for MySQL databases. So better be careful and select the generation type yourself. The generation type identity is the easiest to use, but not the best one from a performance point of view. It relies on an auto-incremented database column and lets the database generate a new value with each insert operation. From a database point of view, this is very efficient because the auto-incremented columns are highly optimized and it doesn't require any additional statements. This approach has a significant drawback if you use Hibernate. Hibernate requires a primary key value for each managed entity and therefore has to perform the insert statement immediately. This prevents it from using different optimization techniques like JDBC batching. Let's get into the IDE and take a quick look at the executed SQL statements. Here you can see a simple author entity with the same annotations as I showed you on the slide. The generated value annotation with the generation type identity tells Hibernate to use an auto-incremented database column. When you now persist a new author entity, you don't need to provide a primary key value, and Hibernate will automatically get it from the database. Here you can see the executed SQL insert statement and the primary key value that Hibernate got from the database. The generation type sequence is my preferred way to generate primary key values and uses a database sequence to generate unique values. This allows Hibernate to apply several optimization strategies and to decouple the generation of the primary key value from the insert operation. That makes the generation type sequence the fastest option to generate unique primary key values with Hibernate. If you don't provide any additional information, Hibernate uses its default sequence. You can change that by referencing the name of a sequence generator in the generator attribute of the generated value annotation. Let's take a closer look at it. Here you can see an author entity that uses a custom sequence to generate the primary key values. I reference a generator in the generated value annotation. It gets defined by this sequence generator annotation. I set the name of the generator, the name of the database sequence, and the allocation size. The allocation size reduces the number of queries that Hibernate performs to retrieve new values from the sequence. In this example, the sequence gets incremented by 10. Hibernate will get a new value from the sequence and increment that value internally until it reaches the configured allocation size. It then performs another query to get the next value from the sequence. Let's give it a try and persist 20 new author entities. As you can see here, the configured allocation size had the expected effect. Hibernate gets 3 values from the sequence before it executes 20 insert statements. The generation type table gets only rarely used nowadays. It simulates a sequence by storing and updating its current value in a database table. That requires pessimistic logs which put all transactions into a sequential order and slows down your application. You should therefore prefer the generation type sequence or generation type identity if your database supports sequences or auto-incremented columns, and that's the case for all popular databases. Here you can see a simple example that uses the generation type table. Let's persist a new author entity and check how Hibernate uses the database table to emulate the sequence. Hibernate first selects the new primary key value from the Hibernate sequence table and sets a write lock with this for update of table clause. That prevents all other transactions from reading this database record until the log gets released. In this example, the table is empty and doesn't contain a value for the emulated sequence. Hibernate therefore inserts a new record and then increments its value. After that is done, Hibernate persists the new author entity, commits the transaction, and releases the log. As you have seen, JPA offers 4 different ways to generate primary key values: auto, identity, sequence, and table. I prefer to use the generation type sequence because it is very efficient and allows Hibernate to decide when to perform the insert statement. This provides the required flexibility to use other performance optimization techniques like JDBC batching. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video and an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate 5. I'll add the link to it to the video description. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!